Hello there, welcome to the Visual Crossing Engineering Tech Talks. Today we're going to be talking about how to build your very first weather API query. So let's jump into the Visual Crossing website. You can see on the screen we have the homepage for Visual Crossing, and I'm going to click on the Query Builder link at the top. The Query Builder is our one place for building weather queries, either to see the data within the browser. You can see right now we've got the weather forecast for New York City for the next 15 days, or for downloading the data, or for building API queries. It will actually take whatever you build here and create an API query. So you may have seen in other videos where we download data. So let's start creating an API query. So let's hit on this API button here. And you can see that we have an API URL. So what is an API query? Why would I use it? So you'd really use an API query like this if you have the need to import weather data in an automated fashion. So for example, maybe you're building an app or a website that needs the weather forecast or historical weather data, or you're using weather data in an analysis tool like Excel or Google Sheets or database import, for example. All those are great applications for a weather API because it makes it easy to create a request for weather data and then retrieve it. And in our case, our weather API is what's called a RESTful API. It is an API that looks just like the kind of URL you'd put in your own browser. And in fact, that's the best way to try and test an API query, to build them, put them in the browser, and see if you're getting the data that you want. So here we have our very first API query. So let's take a look at the various parts. We have the basic URL. So this is our timeline weather API request. Then we have our location, so New York City, New York. And after that, we have our unit group. So we're gonna ask for the data in metric units, our API key. That's how the system knows who I am and what kind of features I can get access to. And finally, the format that I want the data. And we have different formats of data. So here by default, it's using JSON, and we'll come back to JSON in a little bit. I'm going to start off with, though, by using CSV. CSV is a simple format, comma-separated values, that lots of applications can easily understand. And it's essentially a representation of a table. So you can see that I've chosen which part of the weather data I want to download as CSV. So I've chosen the daily data. I could choose the hourly data, or the list of current alerts, or the current conditions. But for now, let's choose the daily data, and I can just copy this and put it into my browser, and I can immediately see the information that we saw over there on the table as a result in a query. So this is the same information, just formatted in a very pure text format so that an application can easily import it. Let's go back here, and if, for example, I wanted to get the data for January rather than for the next 15 days, I could just simply change the dates up here. And now if I run it from January 1st to January 31st, now it's going to update the URL. You can see the change that it's made here is after the location. So we used to have just the location, New York City. Now we have New York City from the 1st of January to the 31st of January. So the other aspect that we should be familiar with is using the JSON format. And JSON is a format that is a lot more structured, has a bit more information to it, but it tells whoever uses that data on the application side exactly what kind of data we have. So it will say, okay, this is a numeric number, for example, for the temperatures. It will also give more context, more information around each of the queries. So let's take a look at what that means. We can, by default, include all the daily data, the hourly data, the alerts, and the current conditions. So we're going to hit copy, put that in the browser, and now rather than seeing CSV data, now we have what we call a JSON formatted data. And I have a plugin on my browser that is formatting JSON automatically. But let's take a look. This is the raw version. This is what you'd see if you put this request into a browser and then opened it, say, in Notepad or a text editor. But the formatted version here gives a little bit more information of what's happening. So it's a tree structure. And at the top level, we have some basic information about the request that we've made. So how much did it cost? So in this case, we asked for 31 days of hourly data, so 744. for what location. Here we are. This is the latitude and longitude that was resolved for New York City. The address, and I could look up by latitude and longitude, or I can look up by address. The time zone, and then we get into the actual weather data. So it starts here. You can see we have a days array, and this days array is the list of days with all those that we had also in the CSV data, but now in a structured way. So we can see that the temperature max for the 1st of January was 12 degrees Celsius, and the minimum was 10 degrees Celsius. Below the days, as a sort of a child in JSON speak of days, are the hours. So there it was 12 degrees at overall maximum for this for the 1st of January. And then hourly wise, we can see that we have an individual temperature for every hour. So at midnight, it was 12 degrees. And then at 1 a.m., it started to go down to 11, just under 12 degrees. So you can get the hourly data and the daily data all within the same JSON request. If you then want to actually see sample code for loading that within, say, Java, here's some sample code for Java. We also have sample code for Python and JavaScript. So it's very easy if you want to take this and create code based off these requests. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments below. And do check back often, because we'll be publishing videos regularly to describe some of the features that we have within the weather data services, and also to answer some of the questions that we receive to help you get the most out of the Visual Crossing weather data products.